Traitor Bergdahl might get more than just freedom, Trump won't be happy about his reward. The entire country has been shocked at the unfolding story of Bo Bergdahl. After abandoning his post, he was captured by the Taliban and imprisoned. To America's humiliation, then-President Barack Obama released 5 Taliban commanders to get the man free. Now, after getting off scot-free, the man might be entitled to a huge reward. And, you can bet President Donald Trump, as well as patriotic Americans, won't be happy as the army traitor might just get to have the last laugh, again. Bergdahl has become the picture of disgrace for the modern military. The man abandoned his post. Instead of serving his country, a role he chose for himself, he ran off. That's called going AWOL, and also dereliction of duty. Soldiers were sent to go find him, worried he was in danger. 6 of those brave Americans were killed. After being captured by the Taliban, America was shocked to learn that Obama traded 5 Taliban commanders for Bergdahl's release. Years have passed, and this month, the military ruled that Bergdahl would not be punished for his crimes. The man was given a dishonorable discharge, instead of the jail time he rightly deserved. Even the President of the United States called it a travesty of justice. If you thought this story couldn't get any worse, get ready. Now, the Army is trying to decide if this traitorous coward is entitled to $300,000 in back pay. No, this is not a joke, $300,000 of your money might go to a man who abandoned his duties, ran away, and cost the lives of 6 brave men. If this turns your stomach, good. You're a human being. The very idea that Bergdahl is entitled to this cash is a mockery of our country and values. Yes, this man was captured by the Taliban, but not for bravely fighting for his country or trying to defeat terrorism. He was captured because he disobeyed orders and ran away like a coward. He was captured because he was betraying his country. That doesn't entitle him to $300,000. That entitles him to go to jail. The very fact that this is a topic of discussion is because of how much Obama politicized the military. Under his administration, pathetic, politically correct people were put in charge of the army and other armed forces. These are people not concerned with protecting the United States, but pandering to social justice causes. That includes the backwards notion of helping out a criminal, like Bergdahl. Even with Trump in the White House and Mattis in the Pentagon, some of these idiots still fester within our military. But, it's not all doom and gloom. It seems like at least someone has some common sense in the discussion. That sounds much better. Make the traitor pay back the cash he earned unfairly from the army. Perhaps this will, in a small way, bring justice to the men who died trying to find him. Unfortunately, only time will tell which way this plays out, but one thing is certain. There's not too many logical people who would applaud this traitor being rewarded with our tax dollars.